Hey everybody, greetings, hello. This is Shelter Radio. It is Tuesday the 28th of April. Tuesday, April 28th, I think. And I show up at around 2 p.m. every day on Facebook Live to play some music. And to do my thing. So, yeah, I hope that everybody's doing okay today. I worked really hard yesterday and got like two things done. that's a little bit of an exaggeration. I got two work-related things done, and I did hang some art, and I... There we go. And what else did I do? I hung some art. And if you've been paying attention to the bookshelf behind me over the last few weeks of doing this, you'll notice that some things have moved. And so I'm reorganizing books back there. And so way up there where my hand is gesturing right now, sort of from here and that shelf right there, that's all the Hegel and Marx and Lenin. Down here is all my books about books. And way over here, this is the Walter Brueggemann stuff. That will all eventually move to other homes. But for right now, that's where everything is living. It's good to have tasks, right? It's good to have things that keep you busy. It's good to have things that keep you structured during the day. I'm going to talk today. I kind of have it on my mind during Shelter Radio to talk a little bit about creativity and where ideas come from. But also, you know, it's important to play a little bit of music.
You're a waste of space, no natural grace. You're so bloody thin. Don't even begin to interest me, not even curiosity. Curiosity, just you don't interest me. Well, you're an energy void, a black hole to avoid. No style, no heart, you don't even start to interest me, not even curiosity. It's not animosity, just you don't interest me. Come on. You're a disgrace, tell me. Why don't you tell me? Why don't you tell me? Why don't you tell me? La 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 la. Tell me, why don't you tell me? Why don't you tell me? Why don't you tell me?
So creativity is an odd thing, and inspiration that leads to creativity is an especially odd thing. And that was a song called Mannequin by a band called Wire. And the thing that I was thinking about as I was working up a couple of the songs in this set, because I'm going to play another Wire song in just a minute, is how different sometimes, or how big the gap is sometimes between your idea of something and the actuality of that thing. Like, so I listened to Wire and I can't do a lot of listening to Wire. Like, I can't do a lot of listening to Metallica and other bands like that. Like, what I've discovered is oftentimes the idea of a band like Wire, or the idea of a band like Mission of Burma, or if we want to get into the kind of, not the post-punk era, but the kind of pop edge era, the idea of a band like Art of Noise. I was always more intrigued with the idea of what that band was trying to do than with the actuality of their output. So I would say, bar none, that Mission of Burma is one of my favorite bands of all time. Nevertheless, I don't find myself sitting down a lot and listening to Mission of Burma's albums, partly because they didn't produce much, but also partly because, you know, there's a limitation on what I'm hearing. And it's hard to describe the limitation. Like, I can hear the reach in their music more than I can hear the grasp. And that's true for Wire as well. Now, one thing that's interesting about that is that the lead singer of Wire, not the lead songwriter, but the lead singer, and I guess the lead arranger of Wire, is a guy by the name of Colin Newman. And I will say that there are two albums by Colin Newman. One is called A to Z, and the other one is called Commercial Suicide. And those two albums by Colin Newman, I go back to again and again and again as a source of creative inspiration. They are just amazing, amazing albums, and I can sit and listen to them backwards and forwards. Wire, not so much. Mission of Burma, not so much. Although I do listen to a lot of the solo people from Mission of Burma, like Volcano Suns and Bird Songs of the Mesozoic, like other projects that they've done. So just to say, you know, you listen to things and you think that that's the idea of it is so massive. And sometimes the execution of it doesn't even have to live up to the idea of it, but the idea can get you through. So I'm very influenced by the idea of Mission of Burma, and I'm very influenced by the idea of Wire, even though I don't listen to a lot of their music. I don't know if that's interesting to anybody but me, but it's just been thinking about today. It's just been on my mind.
There's something strange going on tonight. There's something going on that's not quite right. Joey's nervous, the lights are bright. There's something going on that's not quite right. There's something going on that wasn't here before. Keep your eyes glued to the floor. There's something going on that's not quite right. Be brave, there's something going on that wasn't here before. Keep your eyes glued to the floor. No one's gonna save your life. There's something going on that's not quite right. There's something going on that's not quite right. There's something going on tonight. Joey's nervous and the lights are bright. There's something going on that's not quite right. There's something going on that wasn't here before. Keep your eyes glued to the floor. No one's gonna save your life. No one's gonna.
Okay, here's what happened during my playing of that song. Is that's a Wire song. But I first heard that song because REM covered it right? And so the Wire version is very slow and chuggy. The REM version is kind of upbeat and poppy. And I was having the two versions clashing in my head, and I wasn't sure which one to play. So anyway, those are two songs by Wire. And yeah, like I said, Wire is an amazing band that I hardly ever listen to.
It'll have to do for now. Like the warning is a headache I can just ignore. Fight my mouth around the words, but I only seem to say them when your back is turned. Let all America, let all America, let all America, let all America. Miles and days still can't erase what was tied up in the silence of your apron strings. Miles above the love we made, only heaven knows the doors we close. For heaven's sake, what have I got to put between all those miles of you and me? And when I was strong, I tried to give you reasons, but it all comes down to this. It's the poem of a gas gauge when the tank runs dry. Map the road you know so well. I'm a scarecrow in the heartland as you pass on by. My little America, little America, my little America, little America.
Song Little America is a concatenation, it's a pastiche. Okay, so REM years and years ago did a tour called the Little America Tour, and I remember being in gym class, or maybe it was after school, and seeing I think it was Julian Singer at my high school wearing an REM Little America t-shirt, and it had like an outline of a bicycle on it. And that phrase Little America stuck in my head. Years later, I bought a piece of art that was a blue kind of frosted art glass, kind of stained glass, light blue, that was laid over and framed around this poem. And this poem was called Roadrunner. And it basically, the poem is simple. It's like, you can't outrun me. Miles and days will only underline our days, not erase them. Or miles and days will only underline, you know, the distance between us, not erase them. And that phrase, miles and days, you know, and then the last part of the poem is, but run because you have to under a confusion of stars. I'll be the crazy desert bird running alongside your car. I think that that is just an amazing little poem. And so that phrase miles and days kind of filtered into the song. And I was listening and have always been listening to a lot of Bob Mould. And there's a real kind of Bob Mould acoustic feel to the chording of that and the way that it's put together. But it's a song that I really love. And it's a song that came from a period in my life when I wasn't very good at talking about my feelings, but it talks about a lot of my feelings. And so I like to revisit songs like that because they just do things to me. You know, they get me thinking. All right. So there's lots of stuff out there that you should be paying attention to besides me and my nonsense. So first of all, make sure that you check out Zach Zaya's Poetry Lockdown. And that happens around 4 p.m. every day. Zaya is spelled C-Z-A-I-A. And so he's here on Facebook Live doing the Poetry Lockdown. Definitely check him out. Check out Matt Springer's Quarantine Cabaret. And that's usually Monday through Friday at 4 p.m. Eastern, 3 p.m. Central. Matt Springer's Quarantine Cabaret, also here on the Facebook Live. Do check out and join the Facebook group Kimono My House. They're set up like a little rock and roll club, and they do hour-long sets. They have a schedule of shows all through the week, and so you can get some amazing music and a good variety of music if you join up with Kimono My House. Kimono, like the Japanese bathrobe, here on Facebook Live. My friend Leo Huang, went to college with him, Leo Huang, H-W-A-N-G. He does intermittent awesomeness on the guitar, and so I encourage you to check him out because his instrumental guitar work is really, really good. So that's Leo Huang doing instrumental awesomeness on the guitar. Also on Instagram, if you're on Instagram, I've just joined Instagram and I'm starting to kind of get the feel of it. It's a very different place from Facebook and Twitter, and I guess that's okay. But my friend Rahul Deep Gill is doing on Friday nights at 6 p.m. Pacific, which is 8 p.m. Central and 9 p.m. Eastern. He's doing an interview talk show called Deep in This. And last week he interviewed an activist, and healer, and it was a fascinating conversation. Also, great musician Jonathan Brooke. Jonathan spelled like Jonathan, but without the N. Jonathan Brooke is doing the Kitchen COVID concerts Mondays at 2 p.m. So the Kitchen COVID concerts Mondays at 2 p.m. Man, it suddenly makes me realize that I'm not sure if all of those things are coming out mirrored or if they're coming out straight. I sure hope that they're coming out the right direction. That's my hope. Cover me when I run, cover me through the fire. Something knocked me out the trees. Now I'm on my knees. Cover me, darling, please. Hey, 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 monkey, monkey, monkey. Don't you know you're gonna shock the monkey? Fox the fox, rat on the rat. You can ape the ape, know about that. There is one thing you must be sure of. Can't take any more, darling. Don't you monkey with the monkey. Hey, 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 monkey, monkey, monkey. Don't you know you're gonna shock the monkey? Hey, hey. Monkey, wheels keep turning. A monkey, something's burning. Monkey don't like it, but I guess I'm learning. Shock.
Watch the monkey get hurt, monkey. Shock. 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 Watch the monkey get hurt, monkey. Cover me when I sleep. Cover me when I breathe. You throw your pearls before the swine, make the monkey blind. Cover me, darling, please. Hey, 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 monkey, monkey, monkey. Don't you know you're gonna shock the monkey? Hey, hey, shock the monkey. Hey, hey, hey. Monkey, too much at stake. Monkey, ground beneath me shake. Monkey, and the news is breaking. Shock. 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 Watch the monkey get hurt, monkey. Shock. 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 Watch the monkey get hurt, monkey. Shock the monkey. Shock the monkey. Shock the monkey. Hey. Shock the monkey. Shock the monkey to life. 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 Shock the monkey, 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 shock the monkey to life. Shock the monkey. Shock the monkey. Shock the monkey. Hey, hey. Shock the monkey. Shock the monkey to life.
Oh, it doesn't matter if that's a song that I shouldn't play on the acoustic guitar. I really enjoy playing that guitar on the acoustic guitar. It's just a fun, fun song. And one of the things that I'm enjoying now that we're almost 40 days into this adventure of Shelter Radio is that my calluses have come back, the strength in my fingers have come back, and I'm now able to be a little bit more ambitious in going after music. And here's my hope. You know what I was saying earlier in the day today about bands like Wire and bands like Mission of Burma? Those kind of bands, when I say things like I hope that, or I find that their reach extends their grasp, and like the idea of what they're doing is greater than what I actually experience them doing, I really hope that you find that same extension past the grasp here in what I'm trying to do. Like, I get that this is not the best music in the world. I get it. Trust me. Nevertheless, I hope that there's some kernel in this, some part of this idea that grabs you. And even if you don't necessarily always show up for the music, you at least show up for the attempt, and that it inspires you to go out and do something that stretches you, that makes your reach even farther, even beyond what you can grasp. Because right now we have to be going beyond for one another. We really have to be trying to find ways to create community in a world where a lot of forces have worked hard to completely destroy the community that we have. So It's important.
Walk into my room. Ask me tricky questions. You told me what you say. Immaculate perception. Play by all the rules. So close to the vest. Hoping all's not lost. And this is not a waste. So you're just as far from me as me from you. Make sure that you are sure everything I do. Cause I'm not. Your academy. Your academy. The halls look like this. The rooms are underlit. Still, it must be nice. You're such a perfect fit. What's that I hear? The sound of marching feet. It has a strange allure. It has a strange allure. So you're just as far from me as me from you. Make sure that you are sure of everything I do. Cause I'm not. Your academy. Your academy. Maybe you're right. I shouldn't judge. What's wrong, all right? This is too much. I'm not judging you, I'm judging me. Your academy. My academy. My academy. Your academy. Your academy.
Yeah. All right. So I've been reading a lot lately, a lot more than usual. Grad school did strange things to me. And one of the things it did to me was it completely kind of killed in me the ability to read for pleasure. So one of the things that's been happening during the shelter-in-place stuff, has been I've rediscovered, to some extent, a muscle for sitting down and actually reading and enjoying the process of reading. And so I've been reading this book, sorry, I can't see it, by Ronald Rollheiser called The Holy Longing. The Holy Longing by Ronald Rollheiser. I recommend it. But there's a just a quick thing in here that jumped out to me. And it's from page 4, or IV rather, Roman numeral 4, from the introduction of the Holy Longing. And what he says there is, he says, all our miseries, Pascal once said, ultimately stem from the fact that we cannot sit still in a room for 1 hour. All our miseries, Pascal once said, ultimately stem from the fact that we cannot sit still in a room for 1 hour. And it's really important to me that we be doing our part to find ways to sit still in our rooms, because even though it feels like we're doing nothing, even though it feels like we are just wasting time, we are helping other people. We are helping people who are vulnerable. We're helping people who maybe don't have the kind of luxury and protection of a nice place to sit, or the luxury and protection of things like access to social media. And so I'm very grateful that you take this time with me to try and sit still at least for a half hour or so, and try and spend the time together. So I'm very, very grateful for you.
The girl appears in open windows, hiding in shadows, awaken my fears, but not my nightmares. And I think her name is Mary, remembering the nights we went dancing to the tune of our misgivings. And in the distance, dogs were howling. And I think her name is Mary. Paper Susan on a Tuesday slips on rain soaked sidewalks. I never could take Gabriel disasters, so I had to turn to Mary. And the girl explains monsoon season in the midst of apprehension, my soul washing rain away with ashes. And I'm sure her name was Mary.
Hey, thanks for stopping by today. I'll be back tomorrow at around 2 p.m. Please keep doing your part to protect the least of these, the most vulnerable amongst us. Keep flattening the curve, keep sheltering in place, even as communities are starting to say that it's okay to go outside. It is not yet okay. We are nowhere near through this. Please listen to the experts and please trust the experts when they say that we have a ways to go and we need to go there together, protecting one another. I'm so grateful that you show up. I can't wait until all this is over and we can look one another in the face. We can clasp hands. We can smile. We can embrace. We can dance together and we can say we made it and we're all okay. Let's help to make sure that all of us get there together. I'm so proud of you. Don't stop. I'll see you tomorrow.